couldn't wait to get started on this one, so we're gonna grab the gesso again. I'm gonna just start as the same way I did the last one. I'm gonna put a wash of gesso first, and then a wash of colour. I've chosen a page in my Halloween journal that doesn't have any drawing. There are a lot of illustrations in this book. So I chose a page that didn't have any. But I do want to still see the text. A little bit anyway. Thinking the lime might be nice to start with. And I'm also thinking that this gesso is very annoying. I'm thinking I'm not going to let that dry. This is a pretty limey colour, I'll go with that. I'm just going to give it a bit of a mix with the gesso. So I will just use up the rest of this paint somewhere else and be back when this is dry. Okay, so I have these stamps and I can't remember the brand. It might be a DoCrafts thing. But yes, I'm going to use the back. And I did find a little stamping block. And closest I've got to the plum is the wilted violet, so we'll use that. And we are going to stamp Mr. Bat all over the page. Okay, I'm going to give this a go. I'm going to use Miss Days on this time with slightly darker purple. And I'm going to use some crinkled up plastic. Doing much. Let me try it with the distress inks. I'll try seedless preserve. There we go. Juicier ink, so that will work a bit better. A nice bit of grunge to our page. Let's try and get into the middle there. Okay. go, like that. Next. Add a focal image or two. I want to use the skull. I think I do. Do I want him on some paper? I think I do. Oh, you know what I'm going to use? I'm going to use my stamping block. Press thing. Right. I need some paper. What have I got? Let me just find some paper. Yes. That didn't take long. I've got a scrap of mixed media paper, which would be perfect. Now, I'll use the brown because it's here, and I think it's going to work a bit better than my black. Just doesn't seem to want to work these days. I think I need to re-ink it really, really well. The first time I've used this stamp, so it might not stamp very well the first time. We might have to go over it a few times. He's well covered. It's quite a big stamp here. Ooh, he's cool. Let's give him another go so he's nice and dark. Could have used the purple, really. No. This will look good. And then I'm going to use some distress ink so that he's not so clean and fresh. And white. We don't want him too white. More, maybe just a little bit. Do the distressing first. Let's put the lid back on that. We're going to use frayed burlap and some antique linen. So let's start with the lighting. With the frayed burlap. fussy-cut him. Yeah, I do. I want some of these, so. Vine on that side. Let's see. I would like to get it a bit more clearer on this side. This side I'm not so worried about because he's going to be on there. Cross your fingers so that it comes out nice and clear this side. Yeah, that's nice. And do I want any more? Oh. Just a bit more for texture. This fella down. Use my gel again. Clean, dry baby wipe. Drag or scrape paint onto your page. Now, I think I'm going to bring the orange in. Marmalade. Let's use a knife this time. Rather a lot of orange there, so I'm gonna have to balance it with this page, so we'll add a bit more. of that. Glue fabric fragments. Okay, so fabric fragments. I know I definitely want this. I made him a little bow tie. It's gonna make my book really bulky, but I don't care. He needs that. He needs a little bow tie. Not sure what to do for the rest though. Something like that. So now I need to go a bit mad with this to get it to stick down and hope that my distress inks don't make a horrible mess. Easy, right? Sandwich it in between some gel medium and it should stick. And oh, I just knocked a piece off there because there was a bit there, wasn't there? Oh, it's on the floor, I think. Yep, yeah. That's a back gun. And that is that. Let's think. Stitch sew or staple? Just realised you're looking more at my mess than my page. Green staples. These pages are quite thick because they are a couple pages stuck together. So I'm not sure how well this is going to go through. Oh, not bad actually. I'm just going to put some. It was quite randomly, I think. Went a bit sideways, but never mind. Struggling it, isn't it? I think it's the glue. So we'll leave that. Let's try and get one there. Yeah. And that again. Lovely. Do you want any more? Stop putting my finger in that jar medium. There's staples sticking everywhere now. There we go. Let's try that again. There we go. I'm going to try one more here. Now I'm happy. Okay. Right, let's see. I be very careful with this because you saw it ripped. The only thing I can think of for a metallic highlight is a cheeky little gold tooth. There we go. And I think, with that, that is that page done. So I quite like that. Please check out my other videos if you want to see more in the Halloween Journal or the other mission inspiration prompts. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this. Bye.